For some reason, ping pong came very natural to me. I was so good that the Army decided that I should be on the All-America ping pong team. We were the first Americans to visit the land of China in like a million years.
As great a ping pong player as Tom Hanks is, he's not as good as what Forrest has to become, so we did that using movie magic. You have the actors mime playing ping pong, and then you put the ball in later optically.
We had this thing of clicks of when we're supposed to hit it and when we're supposed to wait.
Come on up, charge up, Tom.
We had to have a metronome so that each character would know when to strike the ball. And then we kept speeding it up and speeding it up. It wasn't that easy. Of course, very typically, they hire the greatest ping pong player in the world to be Tom's opponent. Of course, this guy's never played without a ball before.
Valentino, he's like a world-class ping pong player, and of course, to ask him to pretend to play ping pong is one of the hardest. He had such a tough time.
It was hard for him to play without a ball, but this guy did great.
I don't know how it works. How do these things work? I don't know. But they have it all figured out, and it's usually a bunch of technicians from ILM saying, yeah, well, okay, let's try this.
Our job is to create this ball, which is just a computer-generated image, and animate it within the computer so it matches the timings of their strokes. This was a particularly hard shot because we had an extreme scale change here where the ball is going way off into the distance. So we're trying to study Tom's stroke. Well, he's definitely putting topspin on it, so we've got to, you know, make sure that the ball, you know, has this particular bounce. And it looked like Valentino was returning with slice. So we came up with this final product, and it actually works pretty well. It really looks like they're going whole hog on this.
Jeez, it was very tough. I tell you, it was exhausting playing that ping pong game.